Good day, my viewers at home and my professional colleagues. I'm Ayuba Kodri Olayemi, Financial Reporting and Corporate Reporting Lecturer at Triumph Dynamic Professionals Training Hub, Ibadan. I will be making a presentation on International Financial Reporting Standard. Specifically, I will be presenting International Accounting Standard 23 today, which is titled Capitalization of Borrowing Costs. International Accounting Standard 23, which is titled Capitalization of Borrowing Costs. Now, what are we going to be considering under this International Accounting Standard? We are going to be looking at the overview, the key definition, scope, and recognition. And in the part two of this presentation, our focus will be on measurement, solving relevant questions, and disclosure requirements. Measurement, solving relevant questions, and disclosure requirements. Now, let us take, for example, a typical company, ABC PLC. Statement of profit or loss for the year ended 31st December 2018. We have Naira as the presentation currency. Now, we have revenue, cost of sales as a deduction from revenue to arrive at gross profit. We have other operating income, we have distribution costs, a deduction, admin expenses, deduction, other operating expenses, and we have finance costs. Now, ladies and gentlemen, this finance cost is the major issue under International Accounting Standard 23. Now, as it is a common phenomenon among companies to borrow funds, to borrow money from banks and other financiers to finance their operation, that borrowed money is not without cost. The cost of that borrowed fund is the interest that has to be paid to service it. And this is the focus of International Accounting Standard 23. However, ordinarily, interest on borrowing costs should be expensed in the income statement as we have it here, assuming that ABC PLC has borrowed money. Whatever the interest they have to pay on that particular money must have been part of this finance cost. But with the International Accounting Standard 23, the case is not like that. When we have a borrowing cost on the fund that has been taken for the acquisition, construction, or production of a qualifying asset, The provision of International Accounting Standard 23 is that such borrowing costs should not be treated in the income statement, but that borrowing cost should be capitalized as part of the cost of the asset. That borrowing cost should be capitalized as part of the cost of the asset. Now, ladies and gentlemen, what do we now mean by borrowing cost? What do we mean by capitalization of borrowing costs? As we have said, capitalization of borrowing costs is simply treating borrowing costs as assets instead of treating it as expenses. And we have various examples of borrowing costs. We have various examples of borrowing costs, which we are going to be seeing in the slide that will be what? In the slides. Borrowing cost requires that International Accounting Standard 23 requires that borrowing costs that are directly attributable to the acquisition, construction, or production of a qualifying asset should be included as part of the cost of such assets. Borrowing costs that are directly attributable to the acquisition, construction, or production of a qualifying asset should be included as part of the cost of such asset. Let us now see, what do we mean by borrowing costs? Examples of borrowing costs are, number one, interest expense that is calculated by effective interest method in accordance with the provision of International Accounting Standard 39 or IFRS 9, financial instrument. Finance charges in respect of finance lease recognized in accordance with IAS 17, accounting for leases. Finance charges in respect of finance leases recognized in accordance with IAS 17. Another one, which is the third one, exchange differences arising from foreign currency borrowings to the extent that they are regarded as an adjustment to interest costs. Exchange difference arising from foreign currency borrowings to the extent that they are regarded as an adjustment to what? Interest costs. Those are the examples of what? Borrowing costs. Even other ancillary costs, like, let's imagine a situation whereby a business wants to take a bank loan. The interest that is going to be paid on that bank loan is not only what we are going to recognize as borrowing costs. All these incidental costs on borrowing, like these administrative charges, will still be recognized as part of the borrowing costs or processing fees. All these are part of what should be recognized as the borrowing costs that should be capitalized, provided such borrowed fund is used for the acquisition, construction, or production of a qualifying asset. What do we now mean by a qualifying asset? Qualifying asset can be seen as an asset that takes a substantial period of time to get ready for its intended use or sale. A qualifying asset is an asset that takes a substantial period of time to get ready for its intended use or sales. It's not the kind of the assets that as you buy them, so you put them into use. It must take a substantial period of time. Accounting standard does not really define what that substantial period of time is. It may be a period of 6 months, 10 months, a year, 2 years, 3 years, and so on and so forth. And the example of qualifying assets are property, plant, and equipment. Property, plant, and equipment, power generation facilities, investment properties that are under construction, intangible assets, and inventories that are made to order, provided all these assets will take a substantial period of time before they are ready for their intended use or sales. Before they are ready for their intended use or sales. Besides that, under International Accounting Standard 32, financial instrument presentation, preferential capital can be classified as equity or liability. When preferential capital are redeemable, they are classified as equity, as liability under International Accounting Standard 32. However, if preferential capital are irredeemable, they are classified as equity pursuant to the provision of International Accounting Standard 32. If preferential capital are redeemable, they are classified as liability. And if they are irredeemable, they are classified as equity pursuant to the provision of International Accounting Standard 32. What is the relevance of that International Accounting Standard 32 on International Accounting Standard 23, capitalization of borrowing costs? Now, if preference shares are redeemable, that means that it is a liability. They will be they are liabilities. Because they are liabilities, assuming we now raise preference share capital for the acquisition, construction, and production or production of a qualifying asset, any dividend that we are going to pay on such preferential capital will still be qualified to be recognized as part of the cost of the asset, because even in the income statement, it will be part of what? Finance cost. As a result of that, that kind of what? Dividend must be recognized as part of the cost of the asset. That is, it has to be capitalized. It has to be capitalized. Now, besides this, we are having some assets. Though we may state them to be recognized as qualifying assets, but those assets are outside the scope of International Accounting Standard 23. And what are the examples of those assets? Number one, we have qualifying assets that are measured at fair value. Example is biological assets that are accounted for under International Accounting Standard 41. Accounting for agriculture. Another example of this qualifying asset that is outside the scope of International Accounting Standard 23 is investment property that is measured at fair value model in accordance with the provision of International Accounting Standard 40. Not only that, inventories that are manufactured or otherwise produced in large quantity on a repetitive basis and that take a substantial period of time to get ready. For example, whiskey, they are what? They are outside the scope of International Accounting Standard 4 and 23, capitalization of borrowing costs. Inventories that are manufactured or otherwise produced in large quantity on a repetitive basis, those inventories are also outside the scope of International Accounting Standard 23. Ladies and gentlemen, you meet us in another presentation of International, which is going to be part two of this presentation. This is part one. We will be presenting the measurement of the borrowing costs together with the disclosure requirements, and we are going to get some questions solved in the next presentation. Kindly subscribe to our YouTube and pass your comments in the comment section of this video. Thank you for being with us. Thank you.